Hello friends, today I have come up with a new topic here, quantum numbers. See, each electrons have its own set of quantum numbers. See, they have its own energy levels. They are finding of the electron in space is also being given by these values only. So there the values are given by N, L and ML. So there are actually four quantum numbers. The fourth one I will be telling you in the later stage. But the main three quantum numbers are N, L and ML. I will be telling you what are this N, L and ML signifies as. So first of all, this number indicate the probability of finding the electrons in the space around the nucleus. This is the main theory against this quantum number. So the space where the electrons are found is given by the atomic orbitals. Here. So this quantum number, what it signifies is the major question here asked. So principal quantum number, the first one, N value, the principal quantum number, it is related to the size and energies of the main shell. See, this was given by the Bohr's atomic model, where these are called as shells. So these shells represents as the energy levels. So as you increase the number of shells, the energy level also increases. That means if I say this is the first shell, this is the second shell, and third shell, fourth shell, and so on. So fourth shell has the same more energy as compared to the first shell. So fourth shell will have more energy as compared to the first shell. So N has a positive integer values starting from 1, 2, 3, and so on. Okay. As the N value shell becomes larger and electron in the shell are farther from the nucleus. As more number of shells are there, the electron become farther from the nucleus, and so is the less is the attraction, force of attraction to the nucleus to the electrons, nucleus to the electron, right? And so easy it will be to us to remove the outermost electron from a nucleus. Clear? Fine. As N also means the higher energy levels. Well, this I already explained you. N means the higher energy level. This is the first quantum number, that is the principal quantum number, which gives us the size and energy of the main shell. The more is the number of shells, more is the size of the atom. So this is a table which you all have to remember it, where it is also represented by the shells also as K, L, M and N, and values like 1, 2, 3, 4. So either you can say K shell or 1, L shell or 2. So if I represent it again here, the atomic orbitals, the atoms and the electrons and shells here. So you can represent the shells as K, L, and next one as M, and next one as N, and so on. Clear? So this is what represented by the alphabetical letters also. Next one, second one is a angular quantum number, angular momentum quantum number represented by small letter L. So L has an integer ranging from 0 to n minus 1 for each value of n. So it depends on n now. So L depends on n. So whatever the value of n, it ranges from 0 to n minus 1. I have already explained you here with some examples here. So let me go on with the next step here. Each L value represents its one subshell. So here the values of L's gives us the values of the subshells. It represents the subshells. That means it belongs to which subshell. So the 0 means it indicates S subshell. 1 means it indicates P subshell, D subshell and F subshell. So right. So in the subshells we can find orbitals, which I'll tell you the next quantum number. So the N equal to 1, which I told you ranges from 0 to N minus 1. If I keep N equal to 1, it becomes 1 minus 1, 0. Right. So L value becomes 0. N equal to 1, L becomes 0. So 0 means it is S. So I can write down as 1S. So that's what I have written is 1S. N equal to 2, L value again ranges from 0 to N minus 1. So if I put 0 to 2 minus 1, 2 minus 1 is 1. So it has two values, 0 and 1. So when it has 0 and 1, 1 means P, 0 means S. So it becomes 2S and 2P. So 2S and 2P. Similarly, another one, which when N equal to 3, we can write as L equal to 0, 1, 2. So here it becomes 3, 0 means S, so it becomes 3S, 3P and 3D. So it has 3 subshells here. So when N equal to 3, it has 3 subshells, that is 3S, 3P and 3D. 3S, 3P and 3D. Okay. So this value of L represents as the number of subshells, where each L value represents one subshell. Each L value represents one subshell. So these are the subshells. Clear? So I hope all of you understood with the second one. Now third one, the magnetic contour number, which is represented by ML. The magnetic contour number has the integer values between minus L to plus L. So this is also one of the range given for the magnetic contour number. So this magnetic contour number depends on L value again. And L value depends on N value. So there might be a question asked to you in the exam, then how the contour numbers are dependent on each other. Okay. Yeah, so I was saying that how the contour numbers are dependent on each other. So you have to explain N value, that is a principal contour number, that is angular contour number, and then the magnetic contour number also. Yes. So now the magnetic contour number ranges from minus L to plus L. If you take the value of L starting from 0 to 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, so on. So let us see what is the value of ML coming here. These values describe the orientation of the orbitals in the space. So the need or the requirement of this ML, that is the magnetic contour number, is it tells us the orientation or the shape of the orbitals in the space, shape of the orbitals in the shape, that means how they are being oriented, how they look like, what is the shape like. For the p orbital, I can say p orbital will look like a dumbbell shape here. Don't worry, I will be explaining you this one. So it will look like a dumbbell shape here. It depends on the number of orbitals. How many orbitals this p orbital has? So it becomes py, px, py, pz. It has 3 orbitals. So let me move on to the next one so that you will be understanding much clearly. So here. So I was telling you when L equal to 0, see I told you already ML value depends on L value. So it ranges from minus L to plus L. So 0 to 0 doesn't mean anything. So ML becomes 0, right? When L equal to 1, ML becomes minus 1 to plus 1. That is minus 1, 0 also is included. So our L equal to 1 means it is which orbit subshell it is? It is P subshell. It becomes P subshell, right? So when L equal to 0 means it becomes S subshell. So it has one orbital. How many orbital it has? One orbital it has. It has how many orbitals here? It has 3 p orbitals, right? That is, it is given by orientation of px, py and pz. This only I was explaining you previously. So how to represent these shapes are the px. Just draw 2D dimensions here. So px, draw it with a dumbbell shape here. Px is represented by dumbbell shape here, that becomes on the x orientation, on the x axis. For py, you need to draw in this way. And for pz, you need to draw in this way. You can look at the picture which will be shown on the screen also. Okay. So px, py and pz. Fine. So this is for the p orbital orientation. Clear. So when L equal to 2, it ranges from minus 2 to plus 2 here. So you can write the values ranging from minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1 and 2. So that means it is going to have 5 orbitals. How many orbitals it is going to have? 5 orbitals. How many orbitals? 5 orbitals. For which subshell it is? 2 means it is D subshell. It is which subshell? D subshell. Clear. So on, you can increase the value of L and you can find the ML value. I hope you understood the ML value. How to find out is minus L to plus L. Just put this L value here in the value in this range, that is minus L to plus L. To find the shortcut of this L value, how many orbital it has, you can use this formula as 2L plus 1 also. For example, if I have L equal to 2, put the L value as 2 here. So 2 into 2 becomes 4. 2 plus 1. So 2 plus 4 plus 1, 5. So that means when L equal to 2, it will have 5 orbitals. So it is having the 5 orbitals. Okay. So this formula also you can remember to find the number of orbitals in the particular subshell. Clear. So this I have drawn in the table which I am going to fill you out for you. Just look it carefully, all of you. Yeah, let me proceed here. Number of orbital it has, S subshell, it has how many orbitals here? 1. So it has how many orbital here? 1. So P will have how many orbitals here? 3, right? D is having how many here? 5. And F, what is the value of F is? 3, 4, right? L value is 4. Let me do it here. L equal to 4. So when L value is 4, so you can put it in this formula and find number of orbitals. Okay. So 2 into 4, 8 plus 1. I'm sorry, previously the F value is actually 3. I'm sorry, you can check it here in the table. F value is 3. So put the F value as 3, not 4, it is 3. Okay, it is for the next orbital, next subshell. See, the invention of next subshell is not mentioned here. So f l value is 3, that is for the f subshell. For f subshell, l value is 3. Yeah, l value is 3. I'm sorry, I didn't see it. So 2 into 3 plus 1, so it becomes 6 plus 1 is 7, right? So it is going to have 7 orbitals. How many orbitals? 7 orbitals. So d will having 5 orbitals, f will be having the 7 orbitals. Now orbitals are clear. Now orbitals will be represented by this in this way. So orbitals are clear. Now I'll be telling you this in the electronic configuration. So now each orbital will be having how many electrons is the question. Now each orbital is going to, each subshell holds a maximum of twice as many electrons. So each orbital or each subshell will hold how many electrons? Maximum of twice. Clear? So here, since it is having one orbital, so it will hold how many electrons? 2 electrons. Since it is having 3 orbitals, so it can hold, 1 is holding 2 electrons, 3 will hold how many? 3 into 2 is 6 electrons. 5 will hold how many? 5 into 6 is 30 electrons. And 7. Sorry, 5 into 2 is 10 electrons. Again, done mistake. I'm very sorry. 5 into 2 does how many? 10 electrons. So, okay. 7 into 2, how many it becomes? 14 electrons. 14 electrons. Okay. So, a little confusion. All of you just clear it once again. See here, since it depends on number of orbitals of the subshell, so a number of electrons are found, each orbital will have 2 electron maximum. How many electrons? 2 electron maximum here. So, it has 2 electron, it can hold maximum, it can hold 2 electrons. So, one orbital will have 2 electrons, 3 will have 6 electrons, 5 may have 10 electrons, 7 may have 14 electrons. So, to represent for 3 orbitals, you are going to draw in this way. 3 orbitals, and each orbital will be holding 2 electrons in this way. 2 electron, maximum 2 electrons in this way. As you increase the number of atomic number in the of an atom, okay, as you go on with the atomic number of an atoms, so in this way you are going to hold it. Okay, so d will be having 5 orbitals. How many? 5. 1 2 3 4 and 5th one. 5 orbitals. Clear, all of you? Okay, so this orbital filling or the electron filling, I'll be explaining in the principles of quantum number. Don't worry, in the next video, just for the representation, for understanding this one, you can understand here. So it has 5 orbitals. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So each orbital will be filling how many electrons? 1, 2, 2, 2 electrons here. Just count it, all of you. Put 2, 2 electrons and count it away. And count it away, okay? So next, spin quantum number here. So this represents the property of the electron denoted by the MS. This quantum number refers to the two possible orientation of spin of the electron. One clockwise and another is anticlockwise. So spin quantum numbers tells us the spin of the electron as if there are 2 electrons here. Like S orbital will be having 2 electrons here. Each electron will be either clockwise or anticlockwise. So clockwise or anticlockwise. They will be moving clockwise or anticlockwise. They will be moving clockwise or anticlockwise, and they are represented by plus half or minus half. Either they can be moving plus half, they can be given as minus half, but their orientation or the movement will be of clockwise or anticlockwise. Okay, each orbital, I'm saying, repeating again, each orbital will be having either anticlockwise or clockwise. So since you take this example, since this is for the p orbital, it is holding 6 electrons. So each electron here, it will be clockwise, anticlockwise, clockwise, anticlockwise. This will be also clockwise and anticlockwise. So the representation will be of plus half, for this minus half, again for this plus half, again for this minus half, for this also plus half, this also minus half, plus half and minus half, so on for the d orbital. This d orbital also, this was a p orbital, and this is for the d orbital. Okay, so fine. So this was a spin quantum number, all of you, which tells us the spin of the electrons, which is one electron will be clockwise, other will be of anti clockwise. Okay, moving on to the next examples here. So the distribution of the electron in the subshell, shell and orbitals are called as electronic configuration. Very important concept is electronic configuration. If you move on to the next topics of this structure of atoms, you are going to deal with the electronic configuration of all the atoms present in the periodic table. So you need to write the electronic configuration of all the atoms, all the elements which are been invented, nearly 118 elements which are invented. You need to write their electronic configuration and understand their stability. Clear? So the shortened notation of the electronic configuration is NLX, right? So one example I have shown you here, 1s1, that is hydrogen atom is atomic number is Z equal to 1. So it is given as it N value is 1, right? Since it has one electron only. Since it has one electron only, so its N value is 1. L value becomes when N equal to 1, L ranges from 0 to N minus 1, if you remember the azimuthal one. So 0 to 1 minus 1 is 0. So L is also 0. So ML also will be 0. And MS will be plus half or minus half because it is having only one electron. It is having only one electron. Here, you all know that N means the principal quantum number, L means the azimuthal quantum number, whereas X means the number of electrons, number of electron. Keep in mind all of you, X means the number of electron. So your homework is, this was the one electron having in the hydrogen atom. When you go on with the next atoms or next elements, when Z equal to 2, Z equal to 3, how do you represent this electronic configuration and how do you find their quantum number is your homework. You need to find the quantum number for these elements. Clear all of you? Next video, I am going to explain the principles of quantum number. So do subscribe to the channel if you are new to this video channel and keep watching the next video. Thank you all of you. Thank you and subscribe to the channel.